flight. He rose above all. He changed the game. And became a legend.
This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg, and we welcome you to the opening game of the 1991 NBA Finals. It's the Chicago Bulls out of the East against the Los Angeles Lakers out of the West in what should be an exciting best of seven series. But really, Clark, the story here is Magic Johnson and Michael Jordan facing each other in these finals.
Kevin, it really is the story. I mean, they've met only 12 times since Jordan joined Magic in the NBA back in 1984. Now, it won't just be a one-on-one battle, but these two will be at the heart of everything. First, for the Lakers, the question is, how do you stop Jordan from pouring in basket after basket? I'm not sure they'll find an answer to that question.
Well, when it comes to Jordan, really, you can't look to stop him. You can only try to slow him down. But the other side of that equation, Clark, as you mentioned, is Magic Johnson. And he'll cause a lot of matchup problems for the Chicago defense.
And it starts, Kevin, with his size. I mean, he's so tall and talented with the ball that he's a driving force of the offense. I mean, he runs the Laker offense. Chicago will probably end up putting a bigger guard on him, and then he'd probably look to eat up the smaller guards in the post. We might actually get to see the Jordan-Magic matchup because of that. But even if that isn't the case, you can expect them to try to one-up each other, not every trip down the floor, but throughout the game.
Well, this has the makings of, Clark, I think, a fantastic NBA final.
I'm right with you there, partner.
And now our sideline reporter, Doris Burke, has some info for us. Doris, take it away.
Well, gentlemen, Michael Jordan has been trying to downplay the Magic versus Michael matchup, repeatedly saying it's the Bulls versus the Lakers, not just two people competing. But when he talked to the media this morning, he relented just a bit, and you could see that look in his eyes, and he knew this would be about the marquee matchup. Makes you think he's been sandbagging a little bit coming into this series, gentlemen.
Thank you, Doris. And Clark, they can say it's the Lakers against the Bulls all they want, but really the world is watching Michael against Magic.
Well, it's two of the best players of all time going at it. I know it's a little early to say that about Jordan, but he's shown it so far, and a title would certainly help cement that claim.
Now let's check out our starters for the Los Angeles Lakers. Magic Johnson is out there with Byron Scott, then it's Divots, then it's Worthy, and Perkins. Scott, good. Clark, one thing to note in this game one at Chicago, the Bulls have been great at getting out quickly here at home.
You're so right, Kevin. It is rare if they don't jump out ahead quickly in this building. They do a terrific job of coming out strong and getting that crowd revved up.
And it's the Bulls with the ball. After the basket by the Lakers. Here's Johnson. 2:45 left in the first. Here's Perkins. Puts the hammer down.
Does he make it look easy or what, partner? Trust me, that's not easy.
Oh, I know it. I think he could climb over the backboard if he wanted to. Here's Paxson. Left side, Jordan. Got a hand on it.
Jordan hasn't been sharp coming out in this one. You wonder if he's a bit nervous playing in his first NBA Finals game.
Perkins against Paxson. Fires from the elbow. Cartwright gets the bucket. And we're now all tied up at six. Here's Johnson. No good. Good work defensively by Pippen. They've trailed the entire game. Now a chance to jump on ahead. Back to Jordan. Shoots over Scott. And Jordan gets it to go. Jordan's got his second basket of the game.
Just put the ball in his hands, Kevin, and watch him go to work. He's going to make something good happen.
So, Clark, with this series underway, how do you see the Bulls going after Magic?
You know, Kevin, I think they'll play him similarly to how they played Isaiah in the previous round. Send a lot of doubles his way. Try to get the ball out of his hands right away. I think you'll see some traps in the half court. And Chicago, I think, will extend its defense overall to force him to pass the ball quicker and sooner.
All sound ideas.
Yep.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Bill Perdue's checked in for Cartwright. And B.J. Armstrong has subbed in for John Paxson. The Lakers making a switch here. Here's Armstrong. And closing the shot, even with the foul. Now the two free throws.
First person to foul, team's first. At the line in the Bulls, B.J. Armstrong taking two shots.
And that one misses. Good on the second free throw. Here's Smith. 109 left in the first quarter. Clark, the Bulls completed the sweep almost a week ago now against the Pistons.
Yeah, they were really clicking and left no doubt that this team deserved to represent the East in the NBA Finals. It should be a great one with Jordan and Pippen each with their first trip to the limelight of championship basketball.
And let's go to Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have for us?
Kevin, some serious questions about James Worthy's availability and his ankle heading into this game. When I spoke to him earlier, he said his ankle is improving. It doesn't look to be close to 100%, but hopefully they'll be able to treat it enough to where he can get through the game. They are better off with him, even if he's not 100%, guys.
Thanks, Doris. And Worthy's such a big part, Clark, of this Laker offense.
Boy, Kevin, losing him would hurt not only because he's a great finisher and fills the lanes and is a versatile defender as well, but he's a warrior. He's championship tested. So they'll miss him if he's not able to go at full strength.
The Lakers making a switch here. Scott's checked in. Lakers trail by three. Back to defense. And here is Scott. Throws it up. And again, the Lakers no good.
He's had some problems finding the range here in this quarter.
Michael to shoot. Kept alive. Grant. And good. They convert him the second chance.
You have to block this guy out, Kevin. He's just too active on the board to be left alone.
Smith outside. Back to Worthy. Guarded by Pippen. With the fadeaway. Again, Worthy missing.
Worthy still looks a bit tender out there on that ankle and just doesn't have the same push as normal.
A shot by Jordan, no good. And so we've reached the end of one. Bulls lead by five.
Well, their defense has been superb, Kevin. They're talking, working together, and really making it a challenge to score.
More great action when we return. And now the start of the second quarter. And so far, it's been a closely contested game.
You think back to the last game of the Detroit series, and Jordan was just a huge factor.
Yeah, he was very much on top of his game. 11 of 17 shooting, 29 points, and that was just the beginning. He was a man on a mission and completely silenced that Detroit crowd.
And the basket by Johnson. Johnson's got his second bucket. The Bulls leading by three. This is Mike Dunleavy's lineup. We've got Byron Scott, also Magic Johnson out there, and Williams. And the Lakers have possession. They trail by three. And Clark, back to Jordan's game four against the Detroit Pistons. He did more than just score in that one.
Well, partner, he had a sniff at a triple-double with eight assists and eight rebounds. But one thing that was great was he only turned the ball over twice. Given how much he had the ball in his hands, that's saying a lot.
And how they defend him. I mean, they're all over him all the time.
He was very poised and calculated in his game.
Lakers trail by three. Clark, what should we watch as Jordan checks up Magic?
Well, one thing to keep an eye on is his hands, Kevin. Not so much on the ball as away from it. He always keeps them up and in the past has deflected a lot of passes intended for Magic. Really anticipating the pass and playing defense before Magic even gets the ball.
Here's Johnson. He's covered by Armstrong. Here's Johnson. Hits the elbow jumper. Johnson's got six.
This is what happens when the defense lags. Wrong guy to give an opening to.
Here's Cartwright. Tipped. About 3.5 minutes left in the second. 13 feet out. Jones, no luck. Chicago with the ball. Now here's Jordan. 6 points for him. Shoots a three. Cannot hit. And it's the Lakers taking it the other way. And here is Scott. And no good. And a chance to take the lead. Outside Jordan. Arcs it high. Williams pulls it in. The Lakers trail. It's 2-on-1. Looking at Perkins here. He really stepped up big in that game six against the Blazers.
You know what? The Lakers might not be here now if he didn't have that big game. 26 points, 10 of 14 shooting. He was a force in the middle.
Here's Cartwright. Pass to Jordan. He's guarded by Johnson. The baseline, Jay. And again, Chicago. No good. You know, Clark, thinking more about Perkins with Worthy hurting, they need him to be a big factor.
Well, you figure they need somebody to pick up the slack, and it did happen that way. The bench helped out, too, but you got to give credit to Perkins for putting his stamp on that game.
Here's Armstrong. 2:05 left in the half. To the paint. Kicks to Perkins. It's vertical. Gets the break with a nasty stuff.
That's a good look. Very nice look.
So both teams changing it up here. Here's Paxson, still looking to get on the scoreboard. Not that you would expect much different, but Magic Johnson was huge in that game six.
25 points, and he did an outstanding job of carrying the offense. He also had 11 boards and 8 assists too, Kevin. First